Hey everyone, welcome back. In this video, we are taking a look at how you can spy on your competitors. My name is Rishi, I'm the co-founder of Digital Scholar, and make sure you subscribe to this YouTube channel because we bring in some amazing tech, we bring in some latest tools that is going to help you, and also we bring in a lot of founders to understand new technology and some marketing strategies. So make sure you hit that subscribe button, and also you can go to www.digitalscholar.in where we have launched multiple new courses on email marketing, how to scrape websites, how to scrape data and do cold emailing, WhatsApp marketing, and many more. So make sure you go to the website. You can find all that links at the bottom of this video. Let's get started. Now, if you're an entrepreneur, odds are that you have been worried about your competition more than anything, right? You start feeling anxious when they launch a new product, when they have new features coming, when they launch new courses and whatnot. So we literally undergo a lot of pressure when our competition starts doing well or whatever new that they are up to. But turns out you don't really have to go through that stress because competition can teach you more than they can harm you. Let's see how. And also, by the end of this video, you will also have two powerful tools to spy on your competition and learn from them and improvise and do better than them. So the first thing why you should love competition is they show you what's possible, right? Only and only when they start doing or start improvising their workflows, you understand that something like this was even possible at the first place, and you also get that thought process and you can probably imitate similar workflows and try to improvise on them. So they show you what's possible. They prove that the market exists. So if they're launching a new product, they're launching a new feature, they're launching a new course, and they've been doing pretty well for a long time, you know that the market for that particular product exists, right? So if they're doing well on that, that means the market exists. You can bring something new for the market as well. The competitors can inspire you, right? Now, you don't have to become complacent if you're doing well in your space, and only competition pushes you to do better than what you can, right? So they bring the best out in you. You learn from their mistake. Now, one of the competitors went out of business and I understood what was going on and what was the wrong thing they were doing, right? So this is a real story where one of the competitors, a big gun of the country, they went out of business pretty soon because they were burning money and their product was just not the right fit. Right? So they were from the education background and it just did not work out, and they completely stopped it after 1.5 years of run. I understood, I was observing them from a long time and it just did not work out for them, right? So you learn from the mistakes and you don't want to repeat the same mistakes that they're doing, right? Fifth is understand different business and pricing models. You never thought something like that could also be sold, right? But only when you look at your competitors selling and selling at 10x the price than what you're doing, you should know that you can increase your price of the product, or you can probably break down that product into smaller chunks to sell out to the audience, right? Sky's the limit. You learn a lot. And now I'm going to be showing you top or the best tools to spy on your competitors. These are two of my favorite ones. And the first one is Facebook Ads Library. And the second is Competitors.app. Now, first, let's take a look at Facebook Ads Library. You just go to facebook.com/ads/library or simply search for it on the Google, and something like this is going to open up. All right. Now, what you can do is you can go and search for the advertisements that your competitor is running. All right. So now you can search on the location specific. You can search on the category specific. So here I want to search for all countries and I want to look for all the advertisement that my competition is running. I'm going to pick one example. Let's say I choose Pengjun here. All right. So here is where I can check out what is this person, Pengjun, who is pretty amazing with this advertisement, is running. And you can see all the ads popping up on the screen here, right? Now, this is pretty common, but the thing that you need to really look at is from what time until what time he has been running an ad. For you can see this, he has been running, okay, he ran one ad from June 2 to June 4th, and then he stopped it, so it's inactive. But let's see some active ones. This ad is active for a very long time, okay, and it's basically review based. It's something to do with content multiply formula, and it's a review social proof. He's running from October 1st, 2021, almost 4 or 5 months now. And the point is, you get the idea that this ad has been running for a long time, which means they're doing pretty well. It's been selling. And what I can learn from here is that social proof basically works well. And then I can actually check out the landing page as well directly from here and understand what is the entire communication on the landing page is saying here. Okay, so you can see this is purely review based. More social proof, lot of social proof, and that's how it is being projected here. So love your competition, and you can figure out what your competition is doing from here. Everybody who's running ads, their entire data is available. Remember, only activated ads, which is the ones which are pretty much active right now, you can see that. And the idea is you can see how many ads are active, what they're doing, how's the communication, and look at the, you can see what kind of videos they're making, and you can pretty much benchmark, right? You benchmark, you don't have to copy, literally you don't have to do the same thing over here. For example, if he's using these kind of, this is like WWE Royal Rumble, right? And he has put Facebook trolls, ROAS, clicks, which is pretty amazing thought process. Think on those terms. Can you bring something else? Can you bring maybe some animals fighting on you know? And you can just try to benchmark this and pretty much imitate the concept and not just copy it altogether, right? So this is Facebook Ads Library. The next tool that we have is Competitors.app. Now you can monitor all your competitors' marketing moves, right? And this is free of cost. You can sign up for free. You can check their social media updates. How many followers have they increased in last week? How many posts did they make? What is the ad performance like? What are the new blogs they're posting? What are the website changes they're making, right? Literally in last 1 week, if they made one small change, even a word or even a letter, you can track that. You can change the keyword rankings. You can monitor their SEO. You can check out backlinks. You can check out any other new aspect that they are bringing with respect to SEO. And also with respect to emails that they're sending out, you can even track the emailers from here. So this is one amazing tool that you can do. It only takes 5 minutes a week to know your competition's marketing changes. So every once in a week, I go on this platform, I check out what my competition is doing. I take inspiration and I see whether are we doing similar, are we doing better at some places, are we not doing it better at some places, and then we take a call and decide how to move forward with respect to the marketing campaign. So once you log in over here, so I'm going to show you inside how it looks like quickly. Pretty awesome tool and pretty amazing insights you get out of your competition. And you can in fact use this if you are working for some clients. Just bid them against the competitor, and they will love the fact that if you're winning, of course, they love it, and you can show them pretty much a lot of aspects. Now, okay, I'm going to go to dashboard, and in the dashboard, I can see the social activity post. I can see how much blogs have been posted, how many Facebook posts have been made, how many Instagram pages have been made here, and so on. So you can see all the competition is right up here. You can see what is the kind of engagement somebody is getting on the platforms. On Facebook, Upgrad got 382 engagement, which could be likes, clicks, comments, whatever it is, 382. And Instagram, they got 5,900, whereas Digital Scholar got almost 3,520 in the same time. You can see what is their most popular post. What are the most active competitors, Google ranking, how much are they moving? So you can see Google rankings up and down here. You can see the follower counts as well. What is the growth of the follower count that is happening up here? So that is also possible. You can pretty much see that Digital Scholar has been doing pretty well in terms of the Facebook or the Instagram growth. Then you have the followers growth as well. So again, Digital Scholar doing pretty well as compared to, let's say, Upgrad here. So you get the idea, right? You just benchmark and see how your competitor is performing here. Then you can check out keywords. What are the movements happening? What is the performance like? What is the suggested ones like? And then you can take a look at what are the backlinks that your competition is getting out of this. Not just this, you also get a timeline in what, let's say if somebody made or a competitor made a change like, you know, 6 seconds ago or 10 seconds ago, or they're bringing something new, you can possibly check this out over here. You can check the emails, you can see the website changes that has been brought in, you can see what are the new website changes that you see on the screen here. You can see if they have brought in new courses or any other changes can also be reviewed here, and so on. Pretty handy tool. I spend almost a few minutes every week to understand what my competition is doing just for learning purposes, and I make the best use of this particular platform here. So that's about it. I hope you guys had or learned so much from these platforms, and keep your competition close, because keep your competition and competitors close for that matter, because they are going to be teaching you more than anybody else, right? My name is Rishi. I'm signing off. Make sure to subscribe and like and comment for all the value that is being provided for you guys. You will get a lot of amazing content from here. Let me know what you think about these tools and your learnings from this video. See you in the next one.